Top secret information passes through the offices of British government ministers every single day, and rightly so. The security services, armed forces, and national security planners all answer to our elected politicians. In order for this to happen, secretaries of state need to be briefed on everything from emergency plans to ongoing intelligence operations. The same is true for the health secretary, Matt Hancock, who needs to be kept constantly informed of some of the most sensitive plans for disaster preparedness, especially so amidst the current pandemic. All this is the reason that so many meetings about COVID take place in COBRA, one of the government's most secure facilities. Every day, though, ministers are briefed on matters of the utmost security within the confines of their own offices. This information includes materials marked Strap 1 and Strap 2, two of the top three levels of classification. So, when images of the private office of a Secretary of State leak, we should all be concerned as to how. This is true even when the images are as of something as salacious as an alleged affair. Today's newspaper revelations show the Secretary of State for Health's office in close-up detail and were obtained by unknown means. There can only be three options. Either footage from security cameras within the department, which are monitored by individuals supposedly vetted to the highest levels, was improperly obtained and sold to a tabloid in breach of a set of laws, or the security of the Ministry of Health was breached by hackers who were able to access the feed to Mr. Hancock's office or recordings of it thereafter. Failing this, the third option is an unknown person was able to place a recording device into what is supposed to be amongst the most secure places in Britain. In whichever case, the national security protocols that are supposed to be in place have been flagrantly violated. In previous similar cases, leaks of far less significance have been investigated not by the civil service, but by MI5. And that's exactly what should now take place here. Should the footage have been obtained by a bug, then what has occurred today could not be more serious. A recording device, presumably of some complexity, was smuggled into a secure space and left for hours or days to record every coming and going. No doubt it would have caught sight of many sensitive documents. Equally, if this footage is leaked or hacked CCTV imagery, it is no less serious. The imagery is collected and monitored for one use and one use only, to protect government security. Those responsible for monitoring it are highly vetted, and releasing it may well be a clear-cut breach of the Official Secrets Act. In other words, a crime against national security. Equally, if it was hacked material, then that raises serious questions about the nature of internet security at the heart of the British government and whether further compromises could occur. Until the government explained, though, how such a glaring security breach occurred, none of us can be assured that a similar leak, but this time top secret material, will not occur. Steps will also need to be taken to determine if this incident was conducted by a disgruntled civil servant or, given its sophistication and seriousness, agents of a hostile state. At the very least, all other ministerial offices will now need immediately sweeping for bugs and security staff to be re-vetted to prevent a repeat performance. The Secretary of State will have to answer for his own private actions and whether they have breached any public rules. But for the rest of us, this episode cannot be divorced from the way it has been revealed. And the more those circumstances are considered, the more uncomfortable we should be.